Is it safe to travel to Hong Kong?
For now,
I'm not sure. Yeah.
I'm still a little worried.
Because of the protest, I'm afraid of getting involved in it.
That's a question increasingly being asked on travel websites and social media. Here in Wan Chai, one of the most popular tourist destinations in Hong Kong, as you can see here, very few people. The usually crowded square is almost empty. Well, I myself was asked a lot of times by the tourists passing by, is it safe here? Well, their question and concern tells us the answer. When the protests began in June, Hong Kong's hotels and travel industry started receiving inquiries from agencies and tourists around the world. The Langham Hospitality Group, a luxury hotel operator in Hong Kong, said in a statement that certain segments at our Hong Kong hotels have seen a slowdown. And luxury hotel Island Shangri-La, located in the Central District, said it had seen some cancellations from overseas leisure, group and corporate guests.
Some of the major source markets of Hong Kong, like those in short-haul markets in Southeast Asia, like Japan, Korea, Thailand, Philippines, etc., they might start canceling bookings to Hong Kong. Some source markets might even have group cancellations more than 50% compared to last year.
The numbers say it all. The Hong Kong Tourism Board said that year-on-year growth in visitor numbers slowed to 8.5% in June, compared with year-on-year growth in May, which was 19.5%.
For some of the hotels in Hong Kong, we heard from our hotel trade, there would be, I think, more around single-digit drop in terms of occupancy. And overall, in some of the occupied areas, those hotels might have hotel rates drop more than double digit.
With the protests growing more violent and causing disruption to public transport, tourists have been warned to take precautions in Hong Kong. Travel chaos reached a peak this Monday when protesters prevented the doors of trains from closing and the cancellation of some 250 flights in and out of Hong Kong International Airport left people stranded. Since July, a number of countries have issued travel warnings for Hong Kong, including Ireland, Japan, the United Kingdom, and Canada.
The second half year perhaps is also the peak season for some of our major source market. And agents reflect to us that they have not receiving any new bookings so far. If the situations continue, I believe there would be the whole trade would be affected, and some of the travel agents might even need to consider to close down as well.
The most visited city in the world for the eighth year in a row in 2018, according to the Hong Kong Tourism Board, may lose its momentum if the chaos continues.